This prisoner's having a fit. He was arrested for violence and now he's completely out of it. Under a doctor's supervision, he's being restrained so he can't hurt himself or anyone else. To make matters worse, he speaks no English.
Gemma, could you get me a double crewed unit as an urgency, please?
The sergeant wants an ambulance.
When he was charged, he was sweating and shaking, which are signs of alcohol withdrawal.
One man has brought every custody officer to their knees. CID, then uniform, arrive as backup.
This guy's built like one of the entries to World's Strongest Man.
He's had a fit, he's panicking.
Calm down. What happens in a busy custody suite when there's no one left to hold the fort?
It's the only one here. Calm down.
Welcome to the lockup. On the northeast coast, the city of Hull gets its fair share of booze-related crime. Of 25,000 arrests every year, more than a third involve drugs or drink. And most end up here at the custody suite of Humberside Police Headquarters in Priory Road. The man in charge is Sergeant Pete Swann.
You had your say. I don't want to listen to you either. That's why you're going to a cell.
He leads a team whose job it is to look after everyone, no matter how drunk they may be. Never have so many officers crammed into one cell to control just one detainee. And there are 15 other custody guests demanding room service. Sergeant Peter Swann has no choice. The lockup is shut up.
Can you let everyone know that we're closed? We're trying to send prisoners, but we've got an emergency going on.
I've never had to close the custody suite in all my years as a sergeant until tonight. It's a badge of honour. We don't close unless we have to.
Even the paramedics have to wait for their moment. It's still not safe.
We're going to try and get him on his side to get the hand behind his back and then bring the other one round.
Relax, yeah? No problem.
Have you had the background to what's happened?
Yeah, partially. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and I think what you've seen there has been panic at what we've been doing. The difficulty is he speaks no English whatsoever, so he's got no idea what's happening.
Yeah.
Yes, I am. Thanks. Ambulance.
Okay.
You're going to go to hospital.
Yeah.
It's a real nightmare situation for me, is that? An alcoholic Pole that speaks no English withdrawing from alcohol. And with 10 people all in one cell restraining one person, you can't deal with anything because there's nobody to deal with it, basically. So you just hope the same thing doesn't happen in two places at once, otherwise you're really up the creek, shall we say.
He may be a patient, but he's still cuffed and strapped in case he becomes violent again.
Thank you, everybody. Every man Jack Harry of us has been in the one cell, so that's why we've not been able to do anything.
The shutdown means Sergeant Swann has to tell his boss, while the prisoner is chauffeured away in his own personal motorcade.
I think he'll be OK now, though, cos there's a taser car behind and there's two officers in the ambulance. So, yeah, it's all good stuff. But the tap was on in the toilet during all the fun and games. And eventually it's overflowed. So I'm not quite ankle deep, but I'm bootlace deep in water. So needless to say, when the prisoners press the buzzer, they get in short shrift. Anyway, I'm open to business again.
I'm just going to check that to see if it's stopped leaking now, Pete.
The longest serving lockup staffer is on the case. G Jill, the cleaner of 8 years with her plumber's mate.
Ah, it's just dripped on me. I bet there's a hole in that pipe.
We're generally managers of a custody suite, so if there are faults, deficiencies in stores or issues with detainees, that's our role.
If you look at that side there, where my hands are.
There was a deluge on my hand there when you did that. Anyway, I'll call the plumber.
Before I go home, I'll come and check again, because I've mopped it, and it's not dripping now.
Is there no end to our talent? She'd be the perfect woman if she didn't support LFC, you know.
He's lovely, he's Swanny. We have a bit of banter because we support different rugby teams. So we do have banter, big stat. All friendly, nice banter, though.
The next customer through the doors is up from London for a mate's birthday party.
Have you been in custody before?
Yes.
Yes. Brief circumstances, please.
He was seen urinating in the street. He was clearly in drink.
And he clearly still is.
Sorry.
Yeah.
What's your surname?
Gomez Mendez. Don't barrel.
Do you want to spell it for me?
G.
Yeah.
O. M. E. Z. Hyphen.
That's one barrel.
Yeah.
M from M for
Mullard.
Marilla. E for Echo. N for November. D for December. O for October.
So I've got G I M E Z hyphen M E N D O.
Yeah.
So that's clear then.
Are you working at the moment, Ricardo?
Yeah.
What do you do?
Investment broker.
Restaurant?
No.
No?
Investment?
Yeah.
Broker.
Ah, right. I ain't got investment broker. What sort of line of work is it? Is it
Estate agent.
Is it in a bank? Is it, what is it?
Estate agent.
Estate agent.
Try that.
Ricardo has an international portfolio.
Do you speak any foreign languages?
I do.
What do you speak?
Spanish.
Yeah.
Japanese.
Yeah.
Italian.
Yeah. Is that it?
Mandarin.
Yeah, any more?
And that's it.
That's it?
Yeah.
That's enough, isn't it? What size shoe do you take?
7.5, but I'll always buy 8.
7.5, but you always buy 8. Okay. Easy.
I need pot.
You what?
I need to pass wind.
You need to pass wind?
You need to let it go.
Just don't. Come over to this side for us.
Can you take that as well, just in case you're still feeling poorly? Pretty terrible, really, isn't it? Just out on a night out in court waiting in the street, and then after that, in the cells, it's a bad night. It's not what you want.
Particularly enjoyed the answer to
the shoe size.
I'm a size 7.5, but I'll always buy an 8.
Always buy an 8. You need a bit of light humour, I guess, don't you? Keeps you
absolutely
going.
Absolutely.
Keeps you going.
At check-in, another victim of booze is on the way.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5 times 2010.
The list of previous offences goes on and on.
Once last year, criminal damage, public nuisance. DP has contacted police on 999 system as she wanted a lift from one address to another.
It's no surprise she's been given an ASBO to stop her being a nuisance.
Her ASBO states she cannot call the ambulance service unless a genuine emergency. DP has called 999 and then declined ambulance services when they attend.
And this is her second arrest for antisocial behaviour in the last 24 hours.
Right. She's well in drink and she's been very, very awkward. Shall we have her in her...
The usual M11?
Usual en suite.
I'm going to pull you back.
That break off and we're away.
Are you ready?
Yeah.
Yvonne Jones has cerebral palsy and uses a wheelchair.
Hello. Welcome.
Are you okay with your legs down?
So circumstances, please.
She lives in a block of flats. She has an ASBO, which says that she can't cause disturbance to the neighbours across the way. She's been banging on the door, shouting and swearing at the neighbours.
Arresting officer?
Myself, 224.
Hey, you. 24. 2224. Hey, I'm strong and there is no way that you're going to get away with this. And I will take her up with you. Is it because you're not going to hear?
Yvonne? Have you had any alcohol, Yvonne, or any drugs today?
Yes, I've had the alcohol, yes.
Roughly how much?
Which is a legal substance.
Yeah, it's still legal as far as I'm aware.
Take the money, yeah.
How much have you had today?
Two cans, yeah. Strong beer.
Two cans of strong beer, okay, thank you.
I've been dealing with this lady for the best part of 10.5 years. I cannot explain to you how many man hours, how many police hours, how many emergency services phone call hours she's actually taken of our time.
Right, there you go.
Stuart Constable has also met her many times.
Right. Okay, cool, okay. All right. It looks awful. No, she's in a wheelchair, and when she does come into custody, she refuses to move, and also she's difficult to the point of being obstructive.
Hi, Yvonne. How are you doing? How are you doing?
Can I give you a paracetamol?
Yvonne is well known to the custody nurses.
She comes across as genuine, but she also comes across as attention-seeking. She's quite bright, and I believe she's well aware of the consequences of her actions, and she knows when she phones 999 that there's a good possibility she will end up back in custody. But while she's here, she's got a lot of attention, she's got people looking after her, which I believe is the underlying motive of why she makes these phone calls.
We've had her going up and down the street, in drink, in a wheelchair, kicking off wing mirrors of cars, etc., causing criminal damage. A few years back, she actually sat in a wheelchair, threw a piece of her own feces at me, believe it or not, and hit me with a footplate of a wheelchair, and then promptly got up and walked away. This is something she obviously plays on.
Only yesterday, Yvonne was in for abusing the 999 system again. And that wasn't the only trouble she caused.
Well, she's claiming that she's taken an overdose of ibuprofen. Marvellous.
You know that when she told us, she laughed. And we went and looked and there's only two missing from the blister pack.
I know, but I've explained that. We can't afford to take any chances. She knows the score, unfortunately. We can't deviate from it.
The police escorted Yvonne to hospital, but when she got there, she had second thoughts.
Yvonne's had a change of heart and decided to tell the truth. She's told the nurses that she just wants to be dealt with now and she's not taking any tablets at all. So on that basis, they've discharged her.
Only 24 hours later, and Yvonne's back in for harassing her neighbours. Another breach of her ASBO.
What criminal offence have I done? I've not stolen a bag of anybody. I've not hurt anybody. In fact, it's ironic. I'm 2 weeks off the diploma. I'm a diploma in counselling, and I'm a quarter of a way through a degree in sociology. So I like people.
Domestic violence is often the result of overdrinking. Kerry Taylor and her partner were on the lash until she reported him for attacking her.
Sunday, Kerry. Evening, Kerry. Have you been in custody before?
But now Kerry's been arrested for attacking the police.
We attended in relation to a domestic incident, and so I tried to move her out of the way. She's punched me in the arm. So no, she was restrained and arrested. Yes, she did.
That's a lie.
It's not a lie.
That's a lie.
That is not a lie.
There was a report of a domestic incident. So we attended to make an arrest, and at that point, the alleged victim didn't want us to make that arrest, I think. Within the melee, a police officer was assaulted by the victim, so the offender was arrested, and so was the victim for assault police.
Right, what injuries have you got?
I've got fucking lungs. Then.
Right, I'll put them down.
And that.
You're right.
All right, so we will investigate that matter and then you'll be interviewed.
Detective Coupland is on the case of the victim who phoned up the police but was brought in as the attacker.
2:30?
Yeah.
Tell us what went on.
Right. Sat watching TV, as you do. Knock at the door, let him in.
What have they said to you when they've arrived?
Is he here? So I've said no. Said we can hear him. I said, oh, all right then, so what?
And when you're referring to, is he here? Presumably you're referring to
Peter.
But they did find Peter, her boyfriend of 20 years, and nicked him too.
Mr. Webster, you've been arrested for an alleged assault on your partner or former partner, so I'm authorising your detention here while we investigate that.
He's also been attacked by his own dog.
A dog was set loose, presumably with the intention of biting police officers, but it decided it would bite anybody, and it actually bit the alleged offender.
So there was now an angry victim, angry offender, angry dog, and astonished police.
And then starts running around my house like psychos. With that, a little staffy starts ragging on Peter's foot.
This officer's account does mention the little staffy. Peter made a reference that he would get the dog off in his own way.
He would, but they had his fucking hands pushed so far up his head, even God himself wouldn't have been able to move.
Fair enough. Have a look.
Do you want to just pull you in? Do you want to show my colleague?
Yeah.
He's got a few.
Oh, is that from the dog?
Oh, it's either that or one of your lot biting me.
Yeah, right. I'm not a biter, sir. So more of a lover.
Peter's not smitten, he's bitten.
Now there's blood pissing out all over the floor. So I stood up to go stop the dog and she grabbed my arm, twisted it round and then pushed my head like that on the sideboard unit, hence this.
OK. Which police officer was that?
Ugly-looking bag, about here. Dad, gingery, ready. Browning. She wears too much makeup.
No.
You've got a special diet, Nate.
Yeah, I eat steak every meal.
Right. Did you hit her at any point?
No. Violence ain't my thing.
She said that you raised your right arm, drew it back slightly, and punched her in the left bicep. Can you remember doing that?
Well, I tell you what, I've read some fairy tales in all my life, but that takes the biscuit.
Get somebody help! All right,
Yvonne.
Okay.
She's fully wet herself now. It's all down the front of the pants. She said it's gone into her own boots. So she's just sat there in a massive puddle of her own urine.
Right. Going to have words. What more can we do? Because we know that she's
deliberately
doing.
Now, Yvonne, what's wrong?
It's not the first time Yvonne has wet herself in custody.
Well, why don't you get that wet stuff off? I've given you a boiler soap there to get into. You've got some new clean clothes, basically, to get into. Yvonne, I know that you're not that disabled.
I don't know where you're getting it from.
I'm getting it from the medical professional who've looked after you before.
I'm in an electric wheelchair, 24/7. I really don't.
You are capable of dressing yourself.
I can't even get over to the boiler thing.
Well, you got over before, didn't you?
You was placed by the bench.
Yes.
And you got to the door.
Yes, but this one wheel, yeah?
You still
easy.
Was able to move it on? Because we've seen you.
You're going to have to help yourself.
The fact that she sat and urinated, people might say it's because of her condition, but I know that she can get herself on and off the toilet and she will use that to be more helpless. But it just seemed very harsh.
Sarah is making us some cappuccinos that the sergeant's brought in little packets.
Bloody hell. These are really frothy, aren't they?
We've had a few problems with detainees, being quite demanding, so sometimes it doesn't matter. There might not be many people in, but it can cause a lot of problems.
The party goes on. This boozer's been bounced for stealing a handbag at a 21st birthday bash. Samantha McLean was grabbed by the boyfriend of the bag's owner.
Hey, Samantha, everybody that comes into custody has to go through a risk assessment so that whilst you're here, we can look after you.
Yes.
Set questions that I ask everybody. Have you had any alcohol or drugs in the past 24 hours?
I've had alcohol.
What alcohol have you had?
A lot of drinks.
What, have you got any money?
We have, yes.
Yeah, I've got some money.
We've got 2 20s and 3 10s, but we're seizing those.
Why?
There's evidence to either prove or disprove your innocence or guilt.
It's a load of shit. I came out with that money. I got robbed by my throat by some stranger.
Okay, Sam, you are 18 years old or older and have been arrested for a trigger offence, namely theft.
Yes.
IPC 123. I'm now going to ask you to provide a sample of saliva for testing in accordance with the Police and Criminal Evidence Act 1984.
Yes.
The purpose of the test is to find out whether you have the evidence of the presence of crack cocaine or heroin in your body.
Yes.
If the result of the test is positive, you may be required to attend an initial and a follow-up assessment with a drugs worker and to remain for its duration.
Just do my spit test. I don't need a lawyer. I'm innocent and they're going to see
right.
That.
Samantha, I need you around here, please. Just take a seat on that grey chair.
We drugs test everyone arrested for offences like theft because there's always a suspicion that they're stealing to fund a drug habit.
It's going to be quite a bright light. I just need you to swing round and look into camera for me.
I haven't stolen anything and I just got fucking...
Samantha, don't talk about the offence.
OK, well, I don't take drugs, I don't steal. I've had a very good night tonight, apart from getting arrested.
Have you ever done a drugs test before?
Yeah.
Yeah, so if I give you that, if you put that in your mouth for me. I need your fingers on there for me.
Oh, I've got 2 babies at home. Honestly, just thinking about them now, doing this shit makes me want to cry.
I don't cry. I would never say you're befriending them, but building a rapport so that you're not fighting with them, I think, is fairly important. I mean, you don't want to be on the floor fighting with them to get their fingerprints, which we are legally allowed to do. It's much easier to have a bit of a laugh if they're willing to have a laugh and proceed from there.
I'm gonna find out that I am right and they are wrong. They're gonna let me go.
Say, Samantha, you've tested negative, negative. Grab your shoes that you don't want to lose.
Yeah, please, I don't want to lose the shoes.
There are drunks who are nice people and there are drunks who are bad people. Some apologise, some can't remember, and some don't give a damn. I'm not convinced people can't remember what they've done. It is a good defence to having to explain away quite unacceptable behaviour when you maybe don't want to.
Samantha can't be interviewed until she's sobered up.
Do you want a cup of tea?
You don't have coffee, do you?
I don't.
Yeah, I'll have a cup of tea.
Do you have sugar?
Just one.
OK.
Thank you. At the minute, I feel like fucking shit. All I want to do is go to sleep, just wake up in the morning and go home to my family and my kids. I ain't done anything wrong and I've been locked.
It'll be a long night. Sean Patterson isn't drunk, but he did nick a bag of beer and then didn't come quietly. It took 50,000 volts from a taser to get him this far. Now he fancies giving the cops a taste of their own medicine. came in on suspicion of burglary and criminal damage, but the charge sheet is growing by the minute.
He decided to try and kick one of the arresting officers. Got to say, one of the more pathetic attempts at assaulting one of my colleagues. And within the cell was his clothing being removed in order that it could be searched. And then, coincidentally, it's been seized because he was arrested at the scene of a burglary, so forensic transfers mean that the clothing itself is evidence of the offence.
Fucking surrender, fuckhead!
Patterson is very well known to DC Rob O'Neill.
Sean's been getting in trouble for years now. He's only just come out of prison. He's been out 16 days. And there's been a spike already in that area, which is the area he offends. So crimes have gone up. His particular crime of choice has gone up since he's been out. And it was the same last time. And then when he got sentenced last time, crime went down, virtually stopped.
And what did he steal this time? All this aggro over a few cans of beer.
I've got a simple job for you.
Ryan sent him. He's got away with a lady.
It's a lad called Patterson.
Nasty piece of work.
He's in for burglaries and a dwelling, damage, assault, police, and resist arrest.
It's up to the Crown Prosecution Service to decide what charges Patterson will face.
The lager is actually out of date, and she bought it last year. And this is out of date, and the box, the serial number matches with what's on the cans.
The CPS lawyer that's picked it up is really positive, to be honest. But I think it should be good news, and then we're getting charged.
Okay, right, the CPS made a decision on what you're going to get charged with, all right?
And it's a long list, including criminal damage.
Without lawful excuse, damage offence of value unknown belonging to Robert Wright.
Kicking his arresting officer.
Assaulted PC 2468 Stevens, a constable in the execution of his duty.
And nicking the beer.
Having entered as a trespasser part of a dwelling, namely a garage, stole therein food and beer of a value unknown.
Don't you just sign on there to say the charges have been read out to you? You're not going to be getting bail today. You're going to be kept in for court in the morning. All right?
Sorry, where's this? Are you all fucking idiots?
If Patterson is convicted on all counts, it'll bring the total on his rap sheet to 126. Finally, peace returns to Priory Road. But not for long. Yvonne has managed to change into dry clothes, and she's managed to dismantle her wheelchair.
What are you doing with that?
I was buying to get some attention calls. I can't get up to the...
Listen, you can get up.
I said I can't get up.
Listen, I think we've been more than reasonable with you.
I don't think so.
No, because I know that you've got enough power in your top half to pull yourself up.
I've never got enough power in my top half to pull myself up. I've got to put myself inside.
You can actually walk as well, can't you?
No, I can't actually walk. No, I wish I could.
Let's see how you get on.
No.
Yes. You've been difficult for difficult's sake, aren't you? Please.
Yvonne insists she can't get out of the chair unaided. But the camera never lies.
She doesn't know she's in a camera cell, is she?
I don't know.
I don't think so. Not so quickly.
I find it really upsetting to watch because it looks like we're not bothered to help her, but we are. And if you try and help, she will make it really hard for you to even manage to hold her, so she risks falling anyway. But no, I find it upsetting to watch.
At the end of the day, she's done what she said she can't do.
Is that her?
I would think so. Everybody else is tucked up, aren't they?
Wish I was.
By sunrise, Samantha's lost her sparkle.
It was horrible. Cold, noisy, can't go to sleep. And then when you do go to sleep, you've got somebody opening your door, like, to check, see if you're still alive and that. I suppose it's the job, but, yeah, it wasn't very nice.
She's still denying she's nicked a handbag.
I hope they do check the CCTV footage themselves, and then they might see it in me who did it. They might see the real person who took it.
But they are checking the CCTV. There's the pink bag. There's Samantha. And there goes the bag with Samantha.
They've got a CD of CCTV, and I was on it doing something I shouldn't have been. I felt stupid. My face started burning. So I just... Camera never lies, does it? Spare of the moment decision I wish I hadn't made. And that's why I'm here. I'm a silly girl. I don't know what I was thinking. You know what they say, don't go out.
It's in the bag. 12 months conditional discharge and £50 to the victim.
There you go, room service.
Cheers.
Well, you don't get this at home. Huh? All right. It's not a very nice feeling to be waking up here. We came up here about 9, 10 o'clock last night. I checked into the hotel, started pre-drinking at the hotel, and then literally just don't remember anything from 12 o'clock onwards. That'll be probably about the 2 or 3 bottles of champagne that I probably drank before I went out last night. In London, obviously, all the investment brokers or bankers, that's all we drink down there. I actually don't know why I was brought in here. Maybe for drunken disorderly, I'm not exactly sure.
Mr. Gomez, do you want to come this way for me?
In fact, Ricardo was brought in for weeing in the street.
Just follow me around here.
But it may not be his only crime.
Have you had a drugs test done before?
Yes.
Alright, so what you need to do is put any mouth for me, get some saliva on it, don't chew it, just get some saliva on it.
Thank you.
Alright, I'm testing for cocaine, crack cocaine, or opiates, heroin.
So much of it is a blur. It's unbelievable. Knowing that I won't be pre-drinking like that ever again.
Do you use any cocaine at all?
When I was 18, probably tried it.
Right, why I say that is because it's come back positive.
Okay.
For cocaine.
As soon as I left the hotel, I could not remember even coming here.
Do you have a skin full?
You might want to put it that way, yeah.
But you can't remember what you did?
No.
What you go up to? All right. So what that basically means is you've got to see a drugs worker while you're here. All right? As long as you agree to seeing the drugs worker while you're here, no further action on it. It's like half an hour.
Yeah, yeah.
All right.
But the hangover is about to get a whole lot worse.
Hello there, we've arrested someone that you guys have got wanted.
Ricardo is wanted by police down south for fraud. They'd like to talk to him about some dodgy share dealing.
Right, you're wanted by St. Albans, you're aware of that, aren't you?
No.
Well, you are.
Okay.
Okay. They're travelling up to see you.
Okay.
Okay, they're at this present moment in town.
Right.
Sorted.
It's been a bad trip up north for Ricardo.
It's just relating to an offence back in 2010, which kind of came back to bite me in the butt 2 years later. Guess what, why they call it karma? What goes around comes around.
Get that off!
Yvonne, the ASBO breaker, was found guilty of breaching her order and was jailed for almost 6 months. Kerry Taylor, the victim of a domestic attack, is now a convicted attacker.
I bet you're married, aren't you? Do you know how I know?
How?
Because you iron your shirts like no one I know.
That might be because he just has standards, Kerry. Do you want to command him a look?
She was fined £210 for assaulting the police officer who had come to her rescue.
See you later, Kerry.
See you soon.
Her partner, Peter, received a caution for his attack on her. High flyer Ricardo was fined £80 for urinating in public, had his drugs took, and was collected by police from St Albans.
He still lives with us in Hertfordshire, so we're actually going to take him back to save for the inconvenience of leaving him here stranded in hell. You could have one less person in custody.
The good news for him, he got a free lift home and was later cleared of all fraud charges. The beer burglar who kicked off got 6 months for his troubles. Convictions for assault, criminal damage and burglary did indeed bring his grand total to 126.
More than our fair share of argumentatives today, so yes, it's nice to finish.
And the man whose seizure closed the lockup denied a charge of threatening to kill. The case was closed and the matter left on file.
I'll be back for more tomorrow, and I'll expect more drunks and more domestics. My theory's always been expect the worst, and then if there's anything different, it's a bonus, isn't it?